100 miles south of San Francisco, there's an old Spanish mission. San Juan Bautista, it's called, and it's been preserved exactly as it was 100 years ago as a museum. Now, think hard, darling. Think hard. You've been there before. You've seen it.
No, no, never. I've never been there.
You're going to be all right now, Madeline. Don't you see you've given me something to work on now? I'm going to take you down there to that mission this afternoon, and when you see it, you'll remember when you saw it before, and it'll finish your dream. It'll destroy it. I promise you.
I was on a mission. My fourth grade mission project, that is. But something didn't feel right. I couldn't put my finger on it. As I got closer and closer, I couldn't help but feel a strange sensation come over me. It was as if I were somehow being drawn to a place I had strangely been before, but from long ago and in my dreams. And then suddenly, as if sensing my arrival, the rain halted, and there it stood. Mission San Juan Bautista. With its colonnade, campanario, and plaza, it hadn't changed a bit from the past.
Mission San Juan Bautista. At first glance, this may seem like any other California mission. A cathedral, a cemetery, a collection of outbuildings, but something far more interesting is happening here. If you close your eyes, you can almost transport yourself back to the 1800s, where life, for most people, was a matter of survival. Let's try it. Let's go explore the past.
Located on the famous El Camino Real, the 600-mile circuit connecting the 21 Spanish missions in California, Mission San Juan Bautista is the 15th of the missions and was founded in 1797 by Franciscan Father Fermin Francisco de Lazuen. Lazuen recruited the local indigenous people, among others, to help construct the earliest mission buildings. As with all missions, San Juan Bautista's main function was to convert Native Americans to Christianity and expand Spanish territory. The Mutsin, followed by the Akuts, lived in the mission where they received religious training. First, they were baptized.
This is a painting of the mission's namesake, St. John the Baptist. These are two baptismal fonts made of stone that were used to baptize Native Americans and Spanish long ago.
Besides being a place to convert Native Americans, the mission also served many other functions. Let's take a look at its architecture and layout to discover exactly what went on in Mission San Juan Bautista. The mission sits in Plaza San Juan Bautista, a large grassy area and the only Spanish plaza left in all of California. Here, various historic buildings surround the plaza, offering visitors a chance to travel back in time to see what life was like during the mission era.
It was the tower again in the bell in the old Spanish village.
Yes?
Clear, so very clear for the first time. All of it.
Tell me.
There was a village square and a green with trees and an old whitewashed Spanish church with a cloister. Across the green, there was a big gray wooden house with a porch and shutters and a balcony above. A small garden and next to it, a livery stable with old carriages lined up inside.
It's all there. It's no dream. You've been there before. You've seen it.
After baptism, the Native Americans were expected to work for the mission. Ranching and farming were essential at Mission San Juan Bautista. Here in the nearby stables, horses, wagons, and carriages were kept and maintained.
Missions owned thousands of acres of land. To keep track of their livestock, they needed to get them branded. The brand for San Juan Bautista was this one. Like most missions, Mission San Juan Bautista had a blacksmith, the blacksmith would help to make wheels for the wagons, tools, and horseshoes for the livestock.
Blacksmiths were considered one of the most important craftsmen at the mission. They were essential to the survival of mission life. The blacksmith's shop had a forge where metals were heated over a charcoal fire. A bellows was used to pump air onto the fire so it would burn hotter. There was also always an anvil on which the blacksmith would hammer and shape his metal. Blacksmiths made tools for the garden and kitchen. He made axes, nails, horseshoes, stirrups, saws, and more.
If you listen carefully, you can almost still hear the sounds of the deep bellows or the anvil being struck.
The mission complex originally consisted of a quadrangle of buildings consisting of workshops, the padre's quarters, including the kitchen, and the chapel with the cemetery running just outside its doors. Just beyond the cemetery lies the remains of the original El Camino Real, as well as the actual San Andreas Fault, which in years past has caused earthquakes to destroy parts of the mission. Inside the center of the mission lies the mission's gardens. The gardens were the center of activity for the mission, where carpentry, tanning, weaving, and candle making were learned. Candles like these were made by repeatedly dipping wicks into lukewarm tallow, then hung to dry.
Over here are some of the watertight baskets that they wove out of grasses and weeds.
And while the kitchen inside served 1,200 people three times a day, the gardens were also used to cook and prepare food.
Look at these grills. You would put coals at the bottom, and then you would crank these levers so you could cook the food. This could feed a lot of people. I mean, imagine how many steaks you could put on these things.
Well, someone would have done it, not me.
This big cast iron pot was used to cook food for many people.
These large grinding stones were used to make a very popular food called atole, a kind of runny soup. Wheat, barley, or corn were ground here to make flour, a major component of the soup. Acorns were also a popular source of nutrition for the mission's Native Americans.
These are some of the pestles and mortars that the Native Americans used to grind acorns.
Perhaps Mission San Juan Bautista's greatest claim to fame is its complex being used as the location for Alfred Hitchcock's masterpiece, Vertigo. Filmed on location, Vertigo prominently featured the mission stables as well as its bell tower.
As you can see, these stables have still stayed intact since they've been immortalized in Vertigo. And to this day, this horse is still here since Vertigo was shot in 1958.
Here's your gray horse. Have a little trouble getting in and out of a stall without being pushed.
This is a wooden cart from the mission times. Look at these wheels. Could you imagine pulling this thing? Well, let's see.
Besides Native American life, the mission also offers a glimpse at the lives of the padres who once lived here.
These are the robes that the padres wore during church service.
On display are many artifacts they left behind that speak to quiet lives of prayer, reading, and music.
These colorful sheepskin hymnals are some of the finest in all the California missions. They are printed very big so people could read them from far away in the large church.
Speaking of music, Mission San Juan Bautista is known as the Mission of Music, primarily because of the work of Padre Esteban Tapiz, who taught singing to the Native Americans and formed a choir of Native boys who performed for many visitors.
Madeline!
Guys, where are you? Wait, where are they? What is it gonna happen?
Open up!
Out of all the 21 missions, Mission San Juan Bautista is the largest. You can tell because this whole church is 188 feet long, 72 feet wide, and 42 feet high. Yikes, that's big.
In addition, the chapel's walls are made out of adobe bricks, which measure 3 feet thick. And that's not all.
The roof and floors are both made of red adobe bricks. When some of the bricks are drying outside, some animals step in them, and now we can see their paw prints today.
Scattered throughout the chapel, these paw prints serve as a fun reminder of the making of the mission and its many animal inhabitants.
Another important detail about this mission is that not only is it the largest, it's also the widest. Why, you ask? Because it has 1, 2, 3 aisles instead of just 1 aisle.
Further adding to the mission's sense of grandness, the walls inside are decorated with bright native-style paintings, as well as columns made to look like marble.
Wait! I think I hear them! Hopefully you enjoyed our trip to the past here at Mission San Juan Bautista. I hope you learned as much as I did. That was pretty awesome, but now it's time to go back to the future.
Don't mess with a missionary man. 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 Oh, the missionary man, he's got God on his side. He's got the saints and apostles backing up from behind. Black eyed looks from those Bible books. He's a man.